When it comes to exposure to toxic chemicals, just a little can actually be way too much, and the toll that those chemicals take over time can actually be life-changing. Sadly, toxins are inside our children even before they are born, and exposure builds from there. Studies in the U.S. show that 89% of children have been exposed to mercury, 83% to organophosphate pesticides, and 100% are exposed to toxins like lead, PCB, and flame retardants known as PBDEs. The amount of these toxins is measured in parts per billion. It's a very small trace amount, comparable to less than 2 tablespoons of sugar in an Olympic-sized pool. Chemical companies, though, say the exposure is too little to make any difference, but I think we can challenge that. After all, pharmaceutical companies know that little things matter. Let's compare the levels of some pharmaceutical products to the levels of toxic chemicals that we might find in our bodies. The antidepressant Paxil is effective at controlling moods at a level of 30 parts per billion. So is the widely advertised Cialis. Albuterol, found in virtually every school nurse's office, works to relax muscles in the airway at a level of 2.1 parts per billion. And the most effective and widely sold birth control device, the NuvaRing, is 100% effective at levels of 0.035 parts per billion. Just the smallest fraction of exposure makes these drugs affect our moods, our ability to breathe, and our reproductive cycle. So doesn't it follow that levels of toxins in parts per billion should actually be an area of concern? Take flame retardants, PBDEs, for example. As the body burden of PBDEs in pregnant women increases, their children's intellectual ability decreases. And we see a similar pattern with pesticides and lead. The impact of toxins on the developing brain is permanent. And in fact, because little things matter, there's really no safe level of exposure. That points up a giant flaw in the way that chemicals are regulated here in North America. The regulations fail to protect children because they assume there is a safe level for these toxins. There's not. Just a few extra fractions of parts per billion of the toxins I've mentioned have proven to negatively affect children's IQ levels by a few points. So few that you wouldn't notice the difference in an individual child. But again, little things matter. Even a slight shift in IQ scores can greatly affect the total number of children who are challenged versus gifted. So let's take a different point of view and think about toxic exposures this way. If adding something in such a tiny amount can have an effect, so can subtracting something. Removing any amount of chemicals from homes can make a difference. You're showing families that little things matter, like using a microfiber cloth instead of a disposable wet wipe, like wiping your feet on a Norwex entry mat to get rid of traces of pesticides, and like removing dust and dirt and bacteria without using harmful chemicals. The choices you offer are part of a movement that's taking place in homes around the world. With Norwex, little things can make a big difference.